It's your boy Jimmy Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxing, reporting live from Fort Worth, Texas. Listen, guys, I'm here with trainer Hector Beltran, Team Virgil Ortiz Jr., improved 19-0, 19 knockouts. Hector, listen, man, you know, it was a hell of a night tonight. Almost a sold out crowd tonight, man. It was a lot of people, a lot of excitement in the air, man. Explain Virgil's performance tonight.
He did okay. Thought he could have done a little bit better, but I mean, at the end of the day, he got the job done. 19-0, 19 knockouts. It's hard to knock someone out, period. So for him to have his streak at 19-0, 19 knockouts, it's exciting.
Well, listen, let me ask you this, Hector. You know, you've been knowing Virgil since he was an amateur, since he was a young boy. And, you know, I think at this stage in his career, it's all about, you know, seeing the different types of styles, seeing the different, you know, things that he's going to learn in the ring. What did you take away, and what do you feel that Virgil learned tonight from Michael McKinson?
I felt like after seeing him, how do I say this? I felt like he learned to stay true to himself.
Okay.
After maybe the fourth or fifth round, he started doing that, and he looked way better. I think he was maybe headhunting a little bit too much and wanted to take the guy out. Again, he's, you know, hadn't been in the ring for a full year. So he says it doesn't play part in it, but I think maybe a little bit it did. But I mean, I still think he did great. I mean, he came out with a victory and a knockout, so that's always exciting.
Listen, bro, it's nothing to take away from Virgil, right? I mean, Michael McKinson was undefeated for a reason. He came all the way from across the pond. I mean, he earned my respect. Hey, and he said, you know what? I spoke with him earlier in the week, coach, and he told me, listen, not too many guys were willing to line up to face Virgil Ortiz 100% knockout ratio. I'm built from a different cloth. I mean, when you hear a warrior say that, man, do you feel that he earned his stripes tonight?
Oh, for sure. Class act Mike McKinson came to fight. He didn't come to just, you know, lay down or whatever. He stuck to the strategy. He did well. He did in some aspects what he was supposed to do. And he's right. I mean, look, this fight was scheduled to, for this date, we were supposed to fight David Avanesian. He sat on a contract for 40 days, never signed it. So, man, you know, that was the fight that was supposed to take place. After that, we were trying to get the Keith Thurman fight for a title eliminator, and that also didn't happen. So, I mean, there's a lot of people who don't understand that we've been trying to get these big names to fight him, and it just hasn't happened. For whatever reason it is, I'm not going to sit here and say that they don't want to fight him, but for whatever reason it hasn't happened, we're trying to get these fights, and now he has a title eliminator, and hopefully, you know, they step up and fight him.
Well, you make a good point, Hector. Like I said, you guys can only control what you can control, right?
Yep.
And that's winning. I mean, you guys have won every single fight that has been placed in front of you guys. And at this point, you know, you guys becoming mandatories. You guys, you know, being in the number one position. I mean, you got the top guys, Bud Crawford, Errol Spence, and, you know, Conor Benn, whoever else is there.
Right.
Realistically, I mean, I know you're the coach, but what do you want next for Virgil, realistically?
A title shot. I want him. I think he's ready. Whoever it may be, you know, Bud and Spence look like they're trying to get a fight done, get done. If they're not available, then whoever's next, Anionis. Anyone who has a title, that's what he wants.
Well, listen, man, we appreciate your time, Coach Hector. Hey, you also had another fighter on the card, man.
Yes, Figo Ramirez, he did great. His second fight, he fought a guy with almost 20 fights.
I saw it.
Yeah, the guy was 16, 13, and I forget how many draws, but the guy was crafty. He was a veteran, and I thought Figo did great. I mean, he used his jab, he used pressure. He also boxed, so it just showed what he can do.
Well, listen, man, we look forward to seeing him, right, continue to rise, continue to improve, and he learned a lot going against a savvy veteran, man.
Yeah,
but look,
definitely.
We appreciate your time, man. Like I said, you're always humble, you're always gracious with your time. You know, we're here in the, you know, post-fight lobby, man. It's 1-2 in the morning. Again, it's your boy Jimmy Blue. Any last shout-outs you want to give, Hector, to any of your friends, family that are back home and watching?
Shout out to everybody in Oak Cliff, all the fans, everybody in Dallas, Grand Prairie, just, you know, anybody who supports us and rocks with us. Thank you.
There you go, man. It's your boy Jimmy Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxing, signing off with one of the best coaches in all the state of Texas and in pro boxing, Coach Hector Beltran.
Thank you.